Yeah, my name is David Coupland and I am a museum guide at the Yorkshire Air Museum. My favourite aircraft in the museum is the Dakota, which is behind us at the moment. In its form as it is now, it's kitted out to carry troops, which it would have done on the morning of D-Day. But not forgetting that it wasn't just D-Day, it was used throughout the Second World War in every form you can think of. The aircraft would be subjected to heavy anti-aircraft fire, which would be penetrating the fuselage. Not forgetting this fuselage, the aluminium skin is only 1 millimetre in thickness. So any red hot shrapnel or machine gun bullets would quite easily go through the fuselage. It was a simple aircraft to jump out of as well. Side exit door, they would clip on and jump. And you've got to remember, fully trained paratroopers in the Second World War, leaving this aircraft, you could get 13 out in 10 seconds. That's how quickly they left the aircraft. The ladder which we see here was the original ladder used with this aircraft. And you appreciate the paratroopers climbing on board. Quite often, they would almost have their own body weight in extra equipment, be it ammunition, stores, you name it. And they would have to climb up this ladder to get inside the aircraft. To drop a paratrooper out safely would be about 110, 115 miles per hour. And it would be at a height of about 800 to 1200 feet, which is the ideal setting for paratroopers to leave the aircraft. This is the famous anchor line, what runs the full length of the aircraft. They would then clip on their static line, which feeds to the back of the parachute. And then when they jump, 15 foot of static line comes out, the parachute pack bursts open, releasing an inner bag which is attached to the static line. But coming out of that and attached to his shoulders are the risers, followed by the suspension lines, and lastly, the last thing to come out of the internal bag is the actual parachute fabric itself.